You're with us on Midcap Radio.
FNO space. Let's get to one midcap stock that's interesting. We are joined by Dilip Dandekar, the chairman and managing director of Camlin. Mr. Dandekar, first take us through your preschool plans. What is the kind of money you are putting in? We understand that you're putting in 1 crore. Is that enough? Will you be raising money? Take us through your entire preschool plan.
Actually, this preschool is a model school which we are trying to experiment whether we are successful in venturing into this new project or not. So there will be one model school which will be opened in Mumbai, and on the getting the success in terms of our syllabus or our confidence level about the Camlin's brand equity, everything will depend on first year of experiment.
And what is the amount of money you are planning to pool into this venture, or is that as yet undecided?
No, actually right now nothing has been decided. It all depends on the success and the how our brand equity value is been accepted by the parents. It all depends on that. So that this is all experiments. Mm-hmm. And I think if we are successful in the one model school, then repeating it into a number of will not be a much problem for
right.
us.
Dilip, could you comment on the kind of growth you've been seeing within the segments of, you know, all the stationery and other products that you do? Maybe I'm wrong on this, but at some point I thought you were also doing something in real estate, or you were planning to sell some of your real estate. Could you comment on both, the kind of growth rates you've seen in the business, and if there was a real estate angle at one point?
See, basically, most of our products were unfortunately reserved for small scale right from 1975 onwards. So there was no much opportunity available for Camlin to invest in capex and really invest into a technology products. Last 2 years, with all the efforts and struggle what our company and the many color manufacturing has done, we have managed to de-reserve our color manufacturing activity. And as a result, we decided that we should invest into a technology product. And for that, basically the funds were very important, because by taking the debt, it is not possible. There was a proposal that how to retain the brand equity and the brand goodwill of the company. So we fortunately had the asset in Mumbai, because since we have shifted all our production from Mumbai to other manufacturing units, there was no further opportunity to start anything in the Mumbai activity, Mumbai real estate. That's why we sold the Mumbai real estate and invested most of the money in VRS for the Andheri workmen, as well as investment in the capex.
Right, Dilip, just a quick question that I wanted to ask you was, we've seen the Future Group tie up with Staples, we've seen Today's Pen try and start Offix. Have you looked at retailing, which means retailing of your products or all office products? Is that a model you've looked at or allocated money for it?
No, basically, since our distribution channel is not restricted to very few outlets, because it has a very wide distribution throughout length and breadth of the country. So we are not having any tie-up with any big company or another, but basically since the Camel and Camlin brand has a tremendous brand equity.
Okay.
Every international company who enters into India always would like to keep the Camlin product.
Mr. Dandekar, can you give us an idea of how demand is growing in rural and urban areas? Are you seeing any saturation of demand in urban areas? What is your percentage rural-urban breakup, and how are the rural demand growing?
See, today if you see in every segment in infrastructure, most of the development which is taking place in either rural or semi-urban area. And naturally, the whether the schools or whether the residential areas are coming into that places where new consumers are being generated, and we get the more opportunities. So our entire focus now in future is going to further widen our distribution network, and the rural market is definitely picking up. They have been getting exposed to the good brands, good value for the product, and naturally Camel and Camlin, which is known to the consumers for last 75 years, anywhere we do the distribution, we'll get the better
okay,
opportunity.
Okay, Mr. Dandekar, we're out of time. Thank you very much for joining us with your thoughts. Take a break. We'll come up with more on the market. They're trending fine at the moment.